invented seconds? Are they real? What if our whole idea of time based on seconds and extended to years and millennia is just wrong? What if everything we know is wrong? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews, just trying not to freak out over here. Our system of time seems so inevitable, like math. It just seems to be out there in the universe, waiting to be put into words by humans, but not really. Ancient cultures just kind of made it up. A variety of ancient cultures used different bases for systems of counting, like the metric system, which is a base 10 system, which makes sense. Most of us have 10 fingers to count on. But other systems were just as widely used, like the duodecimal system, which uses 12 as a base. Maybe 12 became such an important number because it takes 12 lunar cycles to make one trip around the sun, or maybe even more basic than that. Rather than counting fingers, people counted knuckles with their thumbs. Or maybe blame the stars. Some cultures used to keep track of the time by the sky. The ancient Egyptians used sundials during the day and divided the day into 12 parts, but at night they found 36 stars that seemed to divide the night into equal parts. They called these decans. There were 18 stars that would appear throughout the night, but some appeared during dawn or dusk, so at true night there would be 12 decans appearing almost 40 minutes apart. Eventually this was standardized so days and nights each had 12 hours, but only on equinoxes were those hours equal. Throughout the seasons, the length of an hour would change. During winter, nighttime hours would be longer and daytime hours were shorter. It really wasn't until the mechanization of clocks in the 1300s did hours become fixed. So how did an hour get divided into 60 units? Well, blame the ancient Babylonians or probably the Sumerians. Over 4,000 years ago, they were working on a base 60 system of counting. Why they picked a base 60 system is a bit of a mystery. Maybe by counting 5 fingers on one hand and counting the 12 knuckles on the other, and 60 is good for breaking down into fractions, who really knows. But what's also important, they divided circles into 360 parts. Ancient Greek astronomers build on these models. They tried to measure the Earth by them. They divided the Earth into 360 parts in a kind of latitudinal and longitudinal lines on a map. Claudius Ptolemy divided these parts into smaller parts, which he called first minute. Then those parts were divided into 60 smaller parts called second minute, which became the second. And it's easy to see how a circular map of the Earth translated into a circular clock face. So these words we use for time came from mapping. But minutes and seconds weren't really used for timekeeping until better mechanical clocks arrived on the scene in around the 16th century. Fast forward a few centuries, and now we have even better timekeeping. We've got the atomic clock. It measures a second by 9,192,631,770 energy transitions of the cesium atom. But this coordinated universal time, UTC, doesn't always match up to astrological time since Earth's rotation is slowing down. So sometimes, around 8 times every decade, a second has to be added to a minute. Eventually, more seconds will need to be added more often. In another century, we'll have to add 2 seconds a year. Well, what do you think? What if we switch to a decimal time system where everything is based on 10, like the ancient Chinese used or some people during the French Revolution wanted? How crazy would that be? Let us know down in the comments below and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.